the Lord, children. How are you all doing? Hope you are all staying safe and healthy. Okay, let's begin our catechism class with a small prayer. Oh Lord, draw us deeper into your heart so that we may know you more. Open our eyes of understanding and wisdom to learn the values we learn from this catechism class today. May our faith in you grow strong. And let's take a note that in all circumstances, I will love God and never go away from Him. Thank you, Lord. Today, I am going to teach you the fourth chapter, God's Name is Holy. The introductory session of this chapter begins with an announcement. It goes like this way. Dear friends, there will be a public meeting today at 6 p.m. at Gandhi Park. The Honorable Governor, Honorable Chief Minister and other respected dignitaries, the official government officials will be taking part in the meeting. The special speaker of the day is Nachimuthu, and Nalini, a famous dancer, will be performing her classical dance. Therefore, we invite all of you to come and participate in this meeting. You might have heard such kind of announcements many more times. All have got names. I think there are nobody in this world without a name. Some names are already forgotten, but many names are there in our minds. Some religious leaders or teachers, political leaders, etc. For example, our national leader Mahatma Gandhi, or other leaders like our Prime Minister Mr. Modi and Mr. Arun Jaitley or Sonia Gandhi, there are plenty more names. So why these names are remembered all the times? What are the reasons behind to get such titles like Mahatma Gandhi, Chacha Nehru? We use these names with full of respect and honor. We shouldn't unnecessarily hail their names. And we have to hail these names certain times in the public meetings and processions and all. We hail Mahatma Gandhi's name, Chacha Nehru's name. But the most important name is God's name. When Israelites asked Moses, "Who is our God? What shall we call him?" That time Moses asked God, "Whom shall I tell about you? What name to be called?" Then God said, "I am who I am." And he again said, "You must tell them, the one who is called I am has sent me to you." That was the answer given by God to Moses. Now we are calling God by many names. That time Israelites were very much afraid of hailing the name of Yahweh, who freed them from Egypt and gave them freedom. They knew that God's name is holy and venerable. We should respectfully call God's name. So different names were given to him, like Yahweh, one of the important names. Yahweh means one who is always there. Then another name was Adonai, means the Lord. The next one is El, that means God. And the next one, El Shaddai. El Shaddai means God of mountain, because God appeared on the mountain and he was as strong as a mountain. In the same way, Jesus has got many names. We call him Jesus, Christ, Emmanuel, Nazarene, Lord and Rabboni. Each name has got its own meaning. Jesus, the Redeemer, Savior, helped us to save from our sins. The next one, Christ, the Anointed One, the Chosen One, we have selected one. Emmanuel means God is with us. Nazarene, one consecrated to God, surrendered to God. Lord, one who rules the world. Now, Rabboni means the teacher or master. And His name is holy. And in the honor of God's name, all beings of heaven, earth, and the world below kneel down in front of him, bow in front of him, and we openly proclaim, openly announce that Jesus is our Lord and the Almighty Lord, the God saved us. He is our Father. In Romans letter, chapter number 10, verses 13, it is said that everyone who calls out to the help of God will be saved. Many, many occasions we hail the name of God. Prayers, bhajans, nambhajan, to strengthen to our spiritual life and beliefs. In all such activities, the name of God is uttered again and again. And we can, especially we call his name when we are suffering, when we are in the pain, and we have got difficult situations and temptations and all. When we pray to Lord, gradually our fear will disappear and our strength, we will be strengthened. We obtain a lot of strength, peace of mind, salvation we get. And our God is in three persons, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We invoke their names, we call them as Holy Trinity, and we invoke their names in many situations, several times a day, especially when we make a cross on our forehead. And in the Trinitarian prayers, like in the Father, the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, then the angels, the Lord declared unto Mary that prayer, then the Holy Rosary, Holy Mass, we say, and the sacraments, and in the blessings, we always call the name of Holy Trinity, the name of the Son, Father, and Holy Spirit. But whenever you say them, utter with the proper respect and devotion. That is very much must. Since the name of God is holy and powerful, uttering his name in vain. Certain times children are having the habit of, promising in the name of heaven, God, etc. You shouldn't call the name of God in vain. And it will be, it is totally a sin. So God's name is holy and powerful. And so, remember one thing, I will never use his name without respect. In vain we don't call him. I will not call his name in this one. Now children, this is the thing about Holy Trinity we learn today. And different names of God, Jesus Christ, and different names of God we learn today. All of this you write it in a book, a paper, and keep it ready. And write a prayer of your own. Okay, it will help you out and say the prayer every day. With today onwards, and take a promise that I will not utter the name of God in vain. And I will pray to God always to strengthen my belief, my trust in God. And more than that, whenever you have got any fear, please pray to Lord. Thank you very much, children. That's all. Shut up.